Hello again, everybody. Okay, this is a pretty cool beginner's card trick. It was sent to me by Mr. Stucky J. Check out Mr. Stucky J's channel. He's got some pretty cool tricks. I actually like his royal scam twist at the end of his trick. I've never seen it actually perform that way. And he actually does this beginner card trick, and he sent me a personal message with the trick, and I thought it was really cool, so I'd like to show you how this trick is done. What you're going to do is you're going to tell the spectator you're going to make a prediction. So you're going to go through the cards and you're going to tell the spectator, all right, that'll be my prediction. So that's your prediction card right over there. Now you're going to flip the deck over and you're going to tell the spectator, what I'm going to do is I'm going to count through the cards, and what I'd like you to do is tell me to stop whenever you'd like. And let's say the spectator says stop right there. Now you turn over the two halves of the deck. And you tell the spectator, okay, I made a prediction. I had you stop wherever you wanted me to. And now, what I'd like you to do is point to one of the halves of the deck that you like. And suppose they point to this half. You turn the card over and you say, okay, that's an eight. So that means we have to count eight cards down over here. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. And we'll set this pile right over there. So now we have three piles on the table. You had to stop at 1/8, 2/8, 3/8, and my prediction was the 4/8. So I watched the trick, and I'm glad he did the tutorial so I didn't have to think too hard because I couldn't figure out the setup right away. So let me show you how it's done. What you're going to do is you're going to take 1/8, place it on top of the deck. Then from the bottom of the deck, you're going to go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and place an 8 in the 8th position and an 8 in the 9th position. Then from the top of the deck, you're going to go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and in the 10th position, you're going to put the 4th and final 8. So you've got 1, 8 on top, 2, 4, 6, 8, 1, 8 in the 10th position. And over here you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 1 in the 8th, 1 in the 9th. And now you're ready to go. So what you're going to do is you're going to tell the spectator what I'd like you to do. What I'm going to do is I'm going to make a prediction. So you can count in threes. You can go 3, 6, 9. This is going to be your prediction card. So hold on to it, but you don't need to predict it right away. Go through the cards, make like you're thinking, and eventually come back to it and say, all right, that'll be my prediction. So it looks like it's a random prediction, and it's really the eight, or one of the eights. Then you're going to flip the deck over. Now you're going to count out cards, and while you're counting them out, you're going to be giving instructions. So you're going to say, what I'd like you to do is, as I go through the cards, I'm going to ask you to have me stop. See how I cleared the two eights? So while you're talking, you're giving instructions, and make sure you pass those two eights when you say, I'm going to ask you to have me stop. So that way they can't have you stop before the two eights. Have me stop wherever you'd like. So now wherever they say stop, you stop and you flip over the two halves. So now you can stall and let them take this in and say, okay, you had me stop here. I have two halves of the deck and a prediction card. Now pick a pile. Now, if they choose this pile, say, okay, what we're going to do here is we're going to count out a certain number of cards. This pile is going to tell us. So that tells us we're going to count out eight cards. So we go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and set this right over here. And then we can turn over and show that we have the 3/8, and our prediction was the 4/8. Whatever pile they choose, they lose. Because if they choose this pile, we say, okay, this card's going to tell us how many cards to count out. And then we count out from this pile. And if they pick this pile, we pick up this pile and say, okay, we're going to use this pile to count out cards. And this will tell us how many to count out. It's just like a magician's force. So I thought that was a pretty cool trick. Thank you, Mr. Stucky J, for sharing that. And that's it. I just want to let you guys know that I am going to be starting my own website called the cardtrickteacher.com, and it should be up in a few weeks. And it's going to be similar to the learnmagictricks.org website. And there's going to be card trick video of the day, there's going to be contests, there's going to be a lot more tutorials, a lot more surprises. So keep your eyes out for the cardtrickteacher.com. So that's it, and I'll see you next time.